Anyone, please. Everyone, please rise as the Woodrow Wilson High School ROTC Color Guard presents our national anthem. Graduates, you may now be seated. Good afternoon, administration, teachers, staff, parents, family, friends, and graduates of the class of 2016. Welcome to the commencement exercises of the Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts High School class of 2016. My name is Alexis Land, and for 4 years, I have had the privilege of serving as the class of 2016 historian. We will now begin this afternoon's ceremony by first hearing from our salutatorian. In her 4 years at Brimm Medical Arts, this student has enjoyed marvelous success inside the classroom. Graduating with a final GPA of 4.04, she has shown a tremendous dedication to an academic accomplishment. In the fall, she will begin her pursuit of a double major in accounting and pre-law en route to an MBA at Virginia Union University. Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to present to you the salutatorian of the class of 2016, Ms.
Good morning, staff, family, parents, and my fellow classmates. Today is the day we have been waiting for since we walked through those doors freshman year during the summer program. At Medical Arts, our time here is now coming to an end. But during our time here at Brimm, we have become a family who has grown into success together. Even though our time here has come to an end, it's the beginning of a new chapter inside the adult world. Today is the day we wanted to come faster, but now it's here, we're crying and say, where'd the time all go? But our success here at Brimm did not come easy. It came from sacrifice, hard work, learning. But mostly it came from sacrifice, sacrifice that we all know, the sacrifice that a hard day of work, you have to come home at 3 o'clock in the morning, you have to drink coffee to just finish your homework or get those final touches on a project. Even though today, officially, I can say that we've made it. We came far enough into an important milestone in our lives. We have those happy memories that we can cherish forever, such as Mr. Rivera's class and all our class pets, the time we spent during senior trip, or how we could throw together a celebration or a party or anything in one day. Or the sad memories that we have, like losing our beloved Nurse K, but we gained a new family member in Nurse D. Today, we all know that Nurse K makes our day brighter and we keep her with us. But I know graduation has not sunk into some of our heads yet. It has for some, but when it doesn't, or when it does, remember these words. A man cannot discover a new ocean unless he has the courage to lose sight of the shore. That means you cannot go on and push further unless you let go. Lastly, we have to thank our family and friends, because without them, we wouldn't be here today. But more importantly, you have to thank the two greatest advisors around, Mr. Abram and Ms. Brady. They care for us, they loved us, and they supported us and made us their children away from home. In this crazy thing we call high school, because of those people, we leave here today with big dreams and the courage and the strength and the confidence that we can fulfill those dreams. Someone told me that becoming a lawyer and going to get my master's and getting an MBA was far-fetched. We had a substitute one day that asked us what was all our college dreams, what was our aspirations, and told me being a lawyer was far-fetched. But I took those words that year in junior year, and I went to Stanford University and did a law school program for the summer. So because of those kind of things, we can remember that even though someone doubted us, we have to push forward. I think growing up in the city gives you a leg up, because we have the strength and determination to push on. That kind of strength, you don't buy. That kind of strength, you can't teach. It's instilled in all of us. And to the class of 2016, I say congratulations, and squad, we out ya.
Thank you, Cherise. At this time, I ask the graduates of the class of 2016 to please rise as we sing our class song, I Doubt, by Mary J. Blige. I made it to the top. You may now be seated, graduates. At this time, I would like to introduce the valedictorian for the class of 2016. In her 4 years at Medical Arts, this student has been a shining beacon of academic and personal success. She will not only be graduating with the final GPA of 4.05, but also as the class of 2016 president. In the fall, she will be attending Rutgers, New Brunswick, where she will pursue a degree in animal science. Ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor to present the valedictorian for the class of 2016, my friend, Ms. Anisha Ames.
Hi, I'm sorry. Good afternoon. I would first like to welcome the family and friends who came out today. I would like to thank you all for showing us endless support and sharing this special day with us. My fellow graduates, over the last 4 years at Brimm Medical Arts High School, we can definitely say that we have truly learned a lot. We have learned that Mr. Abram and Mr. Rivera are crazed hockey fans over the Penguins versus Flyers. We have learned that Ms. Chenimus Walkowitz can never get anybody's name right. Quote, Comrade, Kayla, Alicia, and Alicia. And finally, we have learned that Mr. Medio tolerates no foolishness or talking back in her classroom. As we all know, this knowledge will no doubt be valuable to us as we move on to our next journey in college. However, I believe that the most important thing that we have learned is to be steadfast and never give up on our goals. Throughout our senior year, there has been multiple occasions where many of us were stressed to the point where we're ready to give up and say, just forget about high school. All of the long tests and 5-page papers seem to be coming from a book of ways that teachers can make a student's life miserable. And because we were the senior class, our first instinct was to say, oh, I'm a senior, I don't have to do that, just give me an A. Well, we all knew deep down it was never that easy. We all have had mental breakdowns and major points of frustration, yelling down the halls, just give me my diploma already, impatiently waiting for graduation. And now the day is here, and it feels as though it has come way too soon. The most stressful time of senior year had to be the point when everyone began applying to colleges. Constantly writing papers and running back and forth to Ms. Hall's office caused levels of stress that made you not even want to speak to your best friends when you see them in the halls. But because the class of 2016 remained focused and steadfast, we've completed an amazing goal of 100% graduation rate and 100% college acceptance. As we leave Brimm today and start our new separate paths into higher institutions, let us all remember the great benefits that came with our high school experience. Coming in as little immature freshmen, we were all just getting to know each other and didn't really know what to expect. But now, 4 years later, our bond is stronger than ever, and we like to call ourselves a big happy family. We have gained sisters, brothers, cousins, best friends, and so much more. The memories that we have with each other will stay with us forever, and I wish you guys nothing but the best with your future. I personally believe that the class of 2016 is a special class because in just 4 more years, we'll be the class of 2020 with perfect vision, making a difference all around the world. Sitting behind me, is an ex-pediatrician, lawyer, doctor, neonatal nurse, brain surgeon, neurosurgeon, and so much more. The class of 2016 is filled with nothing but talent and great intelligence, and I'm truly blessed to have gone through this 4-year journey with all of you. With that being said, I would like to thank you all for this high school experience. I would like to thank our principal, Mr. Simons, and the Brimm staff for shaping us into the amazing young adults that we are today.
I would also like to thank the family members and friends for your endless support and sharing this special day with us. I would personally like to thank Ms. Borelli for being my mentor for the whole 4 years and just keeping me on the right path. And I would last like to thank our senior class advisors, Mr. Abram and Ms. Brady. For tolerating us over the past years and dealing with every bit of nonsense that came along with us. Without them, our senior year would be nothing. We love you and we appreciate everything that you have done. Congratulations to class of 2016. Thank you. Thank you, Anisha. I would now like to introduce the superintendent of Camden City Public Schools, Mr. Payman Rahanafard, for his remarks to the graduates.
Thanks, Alexis, Charisse, and Anisha. That was awesome. Really, really enjoyed the remarks. I mean, look at this group. It's an amazingly talented group. Men, you're looking sharp. Women, you got your eyebrows on fleek. You guys look good. It's so great to be with you here today. I just want to say one quick thing, and that's when you think about what's coming up next. I know some of y'all know what you want to study, what you want to pursue, but there are times you're going to pivot, you're going to change, right? Just think big, think bold, don't let anything hold you down. And in doing so, I want you to also think about those who came before you in Camden, those who came before you here at Brimm. Think of the Collazo twins, the first Camden residents to attend Cooper Medical School. Think of Edwin Coleman, who went to Duke University, studied abroad in Morocco, and now works for the government investigating discrimination allegations. Think of Eva Lise Crespo, who is now an attorney working to help new immigrants here in this country, in the local area. Think of Jamil Miller, who I know a lot of y'all know, a Rowan University senior striving to become a cardiologist. And the list goes on and on and on. You've got Dr. Greg King, who's a pharmacist, Chanel Perry, who's a student athlete at Clemson University. And I say all that to say, wonderful things come out of Camden. Wonderful people. Incredible leaders. And they come from Brimm Medical Arts especially. And so think boldly. You've gotten to this point, which means you can get to many, many more places. So that's all from me. Congratulations, class of 2016. So proud of you.
We would now like to call up Damara Hurt.
My name is Damara Hurt, and I had the honor to serve as the vice president for the medical arts class of 2016. This afternoon, I've been charged with introducing our keynote speaker. Mr. Kevin Harden Jr. is a trial lawyer, business advisor, and former prosecutor who works for the national law firm of Ecker, Siemens, Sherman, and Malott in Philadelphia. A lifelong Philadelphian, Kevin was educated in Philadelphia's public school system before earning a Bachelor's of Science from Kutztown University in Pennsylvania, and his Juris Doctorate from the Temple University Beasley School of Law. His practice is devoted to representing professionals, business executives, and companies of all sizes in sensitive and potentially embarrassing matters. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Kevin Harden Jr.
Good afternoon. So I apologize, but I can never speak to graduates with my back to them. So I'm gonna just twist this just a little bit, because as much as I would love for you guys to hear my message, it's really all about you guys. And I also want people to hear it, so I gotta turn just a little bit. So first and foremost, I just wanna thank the Brimm family community for allowing me to be here. It's a privilege to speak to graduates. This is my favorite part of the year. My bosses at work and my clients are all like, are you taking your high school graduation speaker vacation yet? And I say, yes, around this time of the year, every year I take time out to make sure that I speak to graduation speakers so that they understand that it gets better. I mean, this is a great day, so just imagine, it's going to get better. So each year, I give one graduation speech to high schoolers, and every year it changes. And when it changes, it kind of reminds me that the world is frequently changing around us, and number two, that I'm becoming a better and more introspective person. And the story I want to tell today is about permission slips and pancakes. Now, I know you guys are wondering, what? See, the thing I think about the most is that, what would I want to tell graduates if I were sitting in your seats? And I'm like, I had heard this young lady tell this wonderful story about wanting to be an attorney. If I were going to give her advice about how to live her life moving forward so that she could become an attorney just like me, I would tell her all about permission slips and pancakes. So people are wondering, like, what do permission slips and pancakes have to do with life? Well, I'm a junior. My father is also named Kevin Harden. And the hardest part for me was that my dad worked two jobs when I was in school, specifically when I was in high school. He would get up before I woke up, and he would get home after I went to sleep. So whenever I wanted to do anything in high school, I had to get this pesky thing signed called the permission slip. But I never saw my dad. And the thing that teachers got on my nerves the most about were these pesky permission slips. Mr. Harden, did you get your permission slip signed to go on this trip? Mr. Harden, did you get your permission slip signed so you could play basketball? Mr. Harden, did you get this permission slip signed? And then I realized I could just sign my own name because me and my dad have the same exact name and nobody would know the difference. So if anybody ever said, and that's when I knew I was really going to be a lawyer because I figured it out. It's not forgery, it's my name. You forged your dad's signature. No, I didn't. That's my name. And the best analogy for why permission slips, you think they're pesky, but when you really think about it, there are no permission slips in college. It's over. There's no more pesky professor asking you for a permission slip to do anything in your life. The permission slip game is over. Cut it. Permission slip too high, you need to cut it. And I say that all the time because next year I become the president of the African American Lawyers of Philadelphia. And even now, I have to tell lawyers that have doctorates that they don't need the permission to practice law. So many people in this world think you need permission to go outside and be great, and you do not. What I want to make sure that you graduates understand is the same way you don't need permission to get accepted into college or to apply to college, you don't need permission to work hard. You don't need permission to give back. You don't need permission to be great. You don't need permission to make money. I got hired by my law firm after being a prosecutor for 2 years. So for 4 years, I never charged anybody to be a lawyer. I worked for the government. So then when I got my first client, they came in and said, how much are you going to charge me for this? And I ran down to my boss's office and I said, how much do I charge him? He said, how much do you want to charge him? I said, well, I need your permission to ask him for money. He said, well, you're not doing this law thing pretty well, are you? You don't need my permission to take money from somebody. And I thought about it. I said, wow, I'm a lawyer. The person wants to pay me to be their lawyer. I don't need to ask permission to be anybody's lawyer. You don't have to ask permission to do well in college. You don't have to ask permission to do anything. So what about pancakes? What does that have to do with anything? He just looked at me and said, yeah, what about pancakes? So there's a hard part about growing up that I have to warn you about. And I'd be a liar if I stood up here and told you that things are going to always be good for the next 4, 8, 12 years of your educational career. Some of y'all are gonna go and get PhDs, it'll take 12 years. Just be ready. good money though, and then everybody calls you doctor forever and pays you a whole bunch of money just because you're there. Like, you know what I mean? Like, they be like, people look at you and they say, what does Mr. Harden think? And I just nod my head, yeah, and then I collect a check and I leave out sometimes. That's the beauty. That's the beauty of education sometimes. You just sign it. Like, well, the doctor said it was right, so the doctor must pay him. But the pancake part is about what I went through when I was in college. My dad would leave every morning at 6 a.m. and he was a single father, but my mom was around a little bit. My dad would cook pancakes every morning before he left. And he would take these pancakes and put them in the microwave like they were gonna be good when I got up 6 hours later. I was one of those kids. I was the kid that I had 6 alarm clocks, one on my bed, one in the next room. I could not get up in the morning. I still can't get up in the morning, and I'm still a lawyer. You don't need permission to oversleep sometimes. But I used to get so mad that my dad would cook breakfast and then leave it there. And then I got to college, and it wasn't no damn pancakes. And then I spent all my money from my meal plan in advance, and then I didn't have no food at all, and I was begging for some pancakes. But then it got really serious because my dad got sick. And that's what the pancakes is really about. As you get older, the adversities will not stop. I'm from West Philly, 58th and Baltimore. I used to do karate when I was younger, and I would come over to Camden to practice with a master named Thor. And when I look in this crowd and I see the diversity, and I hear about you all overcoming adversities, I want to be the person who helps you to understand that no matter how far away you go, your family and your friends and the people you care about will always be a part of you. So, the thing about the pancakes was when my father started getting sick and he couldn't make pancakes anymore for me when I came home on the weekend, it was a level of adversity that I had never faced before. And no one at that college was willing to be as good a friend to me as the people from whence I came from. So when you talk about permission, you don't need permission to work hard. You don't need permission to be successful. You don't need permission to make money. You don't need permission to give back to your community. But the most important thing I want to charge all of you with for the next 100 years of your lives is that you don't need permission to love the people that love you. The most important advice that I could give to you is to cherish every moment that you have with your loved ones, with your teachers, with all of the people that are here in this room, because those are the individuals who wake up every day and it makes them happy to see you happy. That is so important. So permission slips are over with. Love your pancakes while you still got them. And I have a personal saying, it's on my wall at work, and I wanna make sure I share it with you all because it's a great way to start your day. So when I first walk into work every day, I have this quote, and you guys are a smart bunch, so I know you'll get it. Success is not the result of spontaneous combustion. All right, spontaneous combustion is when you sit something down on the ground and it just randomly sets itself on fire. Success is not the result of spontaneous combustion. You must set yourself on fire. And I added another quote to that quote on my wall that kind of talks about the pancakes part. It doesn't say pancakes, though. My law partners would look at me crazy. This man got pancakes on his wall. A candle that is on fire does not get dimmer or shine less brightly when it lights another candle. So if you set yourself on fire, it won't do anything to your conflagration of flames if you take somebody with you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Harden. I would now like to call from the Board of Education, the Advisory Board President, Ms. Martha Wilson.
Hello, class of 2016. And to all the parents, grandparents, guardians, aunts, uncles, if you were instrumental in any one of the young ladies and gentlemen's lives to get them where they have been thus far, you are to be commended today also. Give them a hand. I am so proud of what you have done to get this far. High school graduation is a moment to pause, breathe, and be proud of what you've accomplished to get this far. But I need you to remember that your work isn't finished yet. Whether you're going off to college, to work, to the military, or remember, this is the moment today that just closes one chapter. Tomorrow, you start a brand new one. I'm going to say to you that on behalf of the Camden Board of Education, I would like to take this time to say that I pray, I had your protection around each and every one of you, physically and mentally. I pray that you continue with the strength that God has given you thus far to continue to go on your journey and do the things that you need to do. Reach back if you need help, not just to your family, those who have helped to get you where you are today. Those are things that have gotten you there. Never forget it. You'll meet new friends, but if they're not the friends that can continue to help you and the work that you are about, let them go. Because you're not here. You don't want anyone or anything to hinder you. You prepare yourself to walk in life. Continue to get knowledge. Know everything that you possibly can. Because you don't know when that door is going to open or a window for you to go through it. You just be prepared and ready that once that happens, you get there and you continue on to your next steps. So I'm going to say, keep moving forward, opening new doors, and doing new things. Your curiosity will lead you down the path of success. May you find hope in every challenge, success in every venture, pride in every accomplishment, and may every step you take lead you to the future of promise. Wishing you every opportunity to follow your heart and explore life's brightest possibilities. Congratulations to the class of 2016.
Thank you again, Mr. Harden and Ms. Wilson. As we continue with our ceremony, but before we completely move on from medical arts, the class of 2016 would like to take a moment to reflect on the sudden and tragic passing of our beloved Nurse K. For 4 years at medical arts, Nurse K's familiar face and compassionate care got us through some of the most challenging moments at our school. At this time, please join me in a moment of silence as we remember our Nurse K. Thank you. And now, please welcome back to the podium the President and Vice President of the Class of 2016, Anisha Eames and Damira Hurt, as they present the gifts of the Class of 2016.
Mr. Rahanafar, can you please come forward? Oh, okay. On behalf of the Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts High School Class of 2016, please accept this token of our appreciation for your guidance and leadership.
And Mr. Harden, please accept this token of our appreciation for your kind words of encouragement and wisdom. And now I would like, oh, sorry.
And at this time, Mr. Abram doesn't know this, but we would like to call up a few special people to the class of 2016. We would like to call up our class advisor, Mr. Richard Abram. We would like to call up one of our senior seminar teachers, Ms. Monifa Young. We would also like to say thank you to Ms. Jennifer Brady in her absence. She was our other class advisor. And we would also like to call up our guidance counselor, Ms. Desiree Hall. On behalf of the class of 2016, we couldn't just let you guys go without definitely giving you something for our thank yous. Throughout the 4 years, Mr. Abram has been our class advisor. He has been like the dad to all of us. We've cried to him, yelled at him, everything under the sun. But yet he still always was there when we needed you. So Mr. Abram, thank you. Next is Ms. Monifa Young. She was our senior seminar teacher. And she took on the duty of handling two classes at one time with over half of the seniors, which was remarkable. From FAFSA to college acceptances, everything, scholarships, she was on top of us. And from the bottom of our heart, we could not do this without you. We do want to say thank you. And last is our guidance counselor. She's the guidance counselor of every student in our school, not just the seniors. And alone, we have 48 seniors. And her office is not that big, but we would have like 20 of us in there, all screaming at the same time, send this out, send that out. We need fee waivers for this, SATs, this and that. And I don't know how she did it, but she definitely helped a lot of us in every way. So Ms. Hall, thank you so much. Graduates, please rise. At this time, the class of 2016 will join the esteemed alumni that came before us as we honor our school with our alma mater. Thank you. Thank you, graduates. You may be seated. Also, on behalf of the class of 2016, we would just like to thank each and every teacher that came to support us today. You guys all had a hand in our education, some freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. Thank you guys so much. Now I call on our principal, Mr. Herbert Simons, for the conferring of the diplomas and presentation of the class of 2016. Mr. Simons?
Greetings, greetings. At this time, I'm going to take a step back and I'm going to call up our guidance counselor for presentations for the awards prior to me, moving forward with confirming of the class. So Ms. Hall, I'm going to ask you to come back up. I appreciate it. Thank you much.
I want to say good afternoon, and I want to say to the graduating class, congratulations and thank you. Thank you. And I also want to say too for Anisha Ames, she had she's valedictorian, but also she had received the most community hours and she received a letter from the President of the United States acknowledging all the community work that she has done. The first name is Anisha Ames. Her scholarships were King Solomon Lodge II, $100, Battleship of New Jersey, $100, Comcast and Achiever Scholarship, $1,000, Prudential Spirit of Community Awards, $1,000, Zeta Phi, Phi Beta, $500, Unique Positive Crew, $1,000, Federal Federation of Men, $500. Cherie Bell, Merit Scholarship Grant, total $40,000. $10,000 per year for 4 years. The Black Law Students Associate of Rutgers Law School, $500. Sharonda Boone, ITT Technical, $5,000. Desiree Brown, Camden School Foundation, $2,000. Sean Bethay, Rutgers Future Scholars, total $48,000, $12,000 a year for 4 years. Michelle Bogazelli, Rutgers Future Scholarship, total $48,000. Jamilette Carrero, Jersey City, full ride, ITT Technical, $5,000. Talia Castro, $48,000 for Rutgers Future Scholars. Nigeria Collins, Camden School Foundation, $2,000. Gira Program, $23,260. Natasha Cortez, Rutgers Future Scholars, $48,000, and the Camden School Foundation, $2,000. Karan Davis, Rutgers Future Scholars, $48,000. Jasper DeShiel, Rutgers Future Scholars, $48,000. The Harriet Tubman Honors Associate Award, $30,000. Natasia Dunlap, Rutgers Future Scholars, $48,000. CCAS Merit Scholarship, $2,000. Kiana Grady, Rutgers Future Kiana Grady, Kiana, for $48,000 and a CCAS Merit Scholarship, $2,000. Wanda Haley is already in college, and she got the American Emergency Relief Organization for $2,900. She's not here with us today because she's in college right now. Alasia Hammond, Nurse K Memorial Scholarship, $1,000. Annika Ibanga, Camden School Foundation, $2,000. Rutgers Future Scholars, $48,000. The Dream Scholarship, $1,000. Spare Change, $500. Darius Epp Memorial, $500. Justin Johnston, Christian Temple Youth Scholarship, $1,000. Phi Delta Kappa, $6,000. Alexis Land Gear Up Scholarship, $23,260. Damira Hurt Gear Up Scholarship, total $23,260. Akasha Mann, Camden School Foundation, $2,000. Talia Nichols, Gear Up Scholarship, $23,260. Kristen Placentia, yeah. Rutgers Super Scholars, $48,000. Kendra Pritchard, Gear Up Scholarship, $23,260. Tasha Nay Robinson, Spare Change, $500. Amanda Roberts, Rutgers Future Scholars, totaling $48,000. Talia Standoval, Rutgers Future Scholars, $48,000, and also the Gear Up Scholarship for $23,260. Joshua Stewart, the Impact Program provided free housing at Rowan University for him, plus giving him a total of $16,000. Emmanuel Vasquez, Gear Up, totaling $23,260, and also Bloomfield, first 2 years is free, and he gets a total of $54,000. Juan Vasquez, Gear Up, $23,260. Courtney Walker, Rutgers Future Scholars, totaling $48,000, and a Camden Education Association, $2,000. Kalia Walker, Rutgers Future Scholars, $48,000. Kyler. Okay, I would like to call Mr. Simons up. No?
I would now like to call up the women of 2000 to the stage.
Good afternoon. The women of Kim Branch of Women 2001 would like to give a $500 scholarship to Karan Davis.
Congratulations, Karan. I would now like to call up Mr. Richard Abram, our class advisor, with the conferring of the diplomas. And following him will be the presentation of the class by Mr. Simons, our principal.
Good afternoon. As we go through our names, I'll ask you to kindly refrain from clapping after each individual student. This way we can get through our list, and at the end we will give one loud round of applause for our class of 2016. First row, please rise. First row, Alexis Charity Lane. Anisha Monet Ames. Damira Lashonda Hurt. Charisse S. Bell. Julia Felicia Lynn Kalk. Emmanuel Vasquez. Talia Castro. Sayer Lee Battle. Kalia Reina Sandoval. Second row, please stand. Samari Shalia Ruiz. Natasha Marie Cortez. Juan Marcos Vasquez. Karan C. Davis. Kendra Nicole Pritchett. Nigeria Nairi Collins. Jamalette Marie Carrero. Kiana D. Grady. Christian R. Placencio. Third row, please stand. And second row, you may be seated. Alasia Monique Hammond. Akasha Mann. Tyra Frisbee. Rashaya N. McCray. Kaishley N. Ramos. Kyla Walker. Sharonda Siobhan Boone. Natasia S. Dunlap. Talia Nichols. Third row, you may be seated. Fourth row, please stand. Courtney Walker. Jasper Tyrell DeShields. Tajanae B. Robinson. Josephina Jamila Hurst. Daquan Witcher. Giera Robinson. Desiree L. Brown. Michelle Bugazzelli. Christopher Miles Henderson Jr. Anikin Abanga. Fourth row, you may be seated. Fifth row, please stand. Justin Johnson. Joshua Anthony Stewart. Sean Bethea. Keon Smith. Jaquan McGill. Rashawn Morgan. Amanda Roberts. Aliyah Muhammad. Shidira V. Tucker. And Brahim Waples. Graduates, please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the graduating class of the Brimm Metro West High School 2016. Thank you. Graduates, you may be seated. And I'll now call Mr. Simons again for the conferral of the diplomas.
Good morning, good afternoon, Superintendent Paymon, Central Office Staff, Ms. Katrina McCombs, Deputy Superintendent, President of the Advisory Board, Ms. Martha Wilson, and fellow board members, distinguished guests, Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts staff, family, friends, and most importantly, the class of 2016. Before I present the class of 2016, I'm going to ask the class of 2016 to stand for me, please. Parents, guardians, friends, and family members, please accept this congratulations on behalf of the Dr. Charles E. Brimm staff, central office, advisory board, members of the class of 2016 for the many sacrifices you endured by assisting and encouraging your child for this commencement day. This day is also yours. Hands to you. Thank you, class. You can be seated. To the graduating class of 2016, I stand before you today honored to have the opportunity to be a part of your educational career for 4 years. 4 years ago, which seemed like last week, I welcomed you all to a new and exciting high school career. You all have made it to the finish line. As we continue to move forward, I say to you this: you have worked hard to reach the milestone in your educational career, and after today, your choices will propel you to all the different directions. Rutgers, Temple, and the many other institutions that you've chosen. Remember, you are the products of the Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts Pride. Pride being the mascot of the lion. Lion's pride, there you go. That same pride that makes you all Brimm Lions in your own rights. I witnessed you all enter and walk the halls uncoordinated cubs, oblivious to the obtaining the depths of knowledge that you walk away with today. You all have the tools to journey out, but keep in mind that you will all come back and give back, just as the keynote speaker made mention to this afternoon. So I see you today as lions prowling for thirst for limitless knowledge and opportunities that await you, your life as a lifelong learner. The circle for the academic life is quarterly complete, is only quarter complete, complete to continue to drink from the fountain of knowledge. So I leave you with this quote. The will to win, desire to succeed, the urge to reach your full potential. These are the keys that will unlock the door for personal excellence. Confucius. All right? What I see in front of me is just that. Give yourselves a hand. So, the time has come that you all wait. It is time for me to present the class. So I say to you, Ms. Katrina McCombs, Board President, Ms. Martha Wilson, as the principal of Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts High School, I present the class of 2016. It is recognized and hereby on the 23rd day of June, 2016, that the Dr. Charles E. Brimm Medical Arts class of 2016 has met their New Jersey state requirements. Class, at this time, I ask you to move your tassels from the right to the left. Family members and friends, I present to you the class of 2016.
Congratulations to the class of 2016. Remember what I told you guys? Take a moment, appreciate the moment that you're in. This is the final chapter in this part of your life. You now have the opportunity to start a new chapter in a new book in your new season. Stay focused, stay prayed up, stay in control. Don't let anyone take you out of your character. Now, I could talk to this class like this, parents. So everybody knows me, knows I love Mary Mary. I'm not going to sing it, but I'm going to take some words from Mary Mary for you guys. Your faith ain't never small. That's what brought you this far. See, you got your dreams, and you got your prayers, and you got your God. He's going to take you there. See, everybody has a season, and I believe this one's yours. Because you've been working, waiting, and this is what you've been praying for. Class of 2016, go get your blessings. Parents, please remain seated as the class of 2016 comes out in their recession. Class, you may stand.